So how much do we really know about the celestial spectacle we call lightning? David Pogue is here to illuminate.
Oh, it's coming right for Sierra Vista. Let's hope it holds together. Oh, there it is.
And there's a little something.
Hi, Storm.
Did you see what's on top of it?
Arizona photographer Lori Bailey is tracking a lightning storm.
I have to admit, I enjoy feeling that the atmospheric energy when you get close to lightning.
Mm.
It's kind of a natural high.
It's not easy to photograph something that's visible for only a few millionths of a second. Let's see that again.
It occurs to me that you have three cameras going.
I do.
Absolutely. How are you going to go click, click, click in time to catch the lightning?
This sensor is what clicks the shutter, because Lori's brain is just too slow to say, there's the lightning. Right?
But there's more to this profession than automated camera triggers and a lot of patience. You also need
that last little thing, right? Luck. You can do everything right and still not have the cards fall in your favor.
When conditions do go her way, the results are spectacular. She posts them online.
When people say, what do you do? I study lightning. Oh, really? And there's always a story.
Philip Bitzer is a lightning physicist at the University of Alabama in Huntsville.
I remember when I was in first grade, my parents explained that lightning happens when clouds rub against each other. I'm guessing the science is a little more elaborate.
That's not too far off base. There is something that rubs and sort of connects to each other. It's not two clouds rubbing together.
Inside a storm cloud, millions of tiny ice crystals collide with slushy hail droplets. The ice crystals blow upward with a positive charge. The slush droplets drift downward with a negative charge. Eventually, an electrical discharge results in a bolt of lightning. It usually stays inside the cloud or hops from cloud to cloud. But the bolts that most interest people are the ones that shoot down to the ground, or seem to.
You know, we talk about misconceptions. Does lightning go up or down? And it starts with stuff that comes out of the cloud, but that stuff that comes out of the cloud, it's so dim you don't make it out with your eye. But the part that you see actually comes from the ground and goes up to the cloud.
A lightning bolt is about the width of your thumb, as bright as 100 million light bulbs, and five times as hot as the surface of the sun.
It will superheat the air right around it, and eventually that superheat will cool off and relax into this acoustical wave that we all know is thunder. So you can't have thunder without the lightning.
You know what's fun about interviewing a lightning physicist? You can get to the bottom of all those traditional lightning tropes, like lightning never strikes twice in the same place.
So it absolutely does. And often what will happen is a single lightning flash, it can hit three to five times in the same place.
Or lightning always strikes the tallest point.
So that's another misnomer. It doesn't have to hit the tallest object. You know, I often say, you know, lightning's already traveled a couple miles from the cloud to the ground. At that point, it's going to go where it wants to go.
We think of lightning striking as being very rare. People always say, you know, you have a better chance of getting struck by lightning than
somewhere around 45 times every second around the world, you'll get lightning. 45 times a second.
All told, about 1.4 billion bolts hit the Earth each year, numbers that are expected to rise as the planet warms. And about 250,000 times a year, lightning hits people.
I remember the sound. It just sounded like it was a bomb going off. Mm. It was almost deafening. And my vision was slow motion.
In 2015, a sudden storm interrupted a school soccer game in North Carolina.
Can you put your head down?
Teacher Shauna Turner sought shelter in the doorway of this shed. But when lightning struck a nearby light pole, millions of volts coursed through the ground and into her body.
I love to watch them run.
I know.
Like the vast majority of human lightning strikes, it was an indirect hit.
At that point, you know, right when the sound was, I was thrown to the ground. Within about a minute, my arm, it felt like it was boiling in my arm. It eventually went to where my feet were tingling. And, you know, within the first couple of weeks of class, I couldn't remember some of my students' names.
Lightning strikes often lead to memory issues, heart problems, and even personality changes. After all, your brain and your heart are electrical systems.
Come here.
There was one instance where I went to call on a student's name and I couldn't come up with it. So I just turned to the board and, you know, tears rolling. I was trying to keep it away so my students didn't see it, trying to choke it back. And he came up to me and he hugged me and he said, you can call me anything you want.
There wasn't much doctors could do.
All I kept hearing was, this is the strangest thing I've ever seen, or what you're describing doesn't make sense.
Eventually, she found a group of lightning survivors on Facebook.
That's when I started to figure out that I wasn't alone. I wasn't the only one having these symptoms. I wasn't crazy.
This is called the invisible disease. They cannot see the neuropathy and how my feet go from burning hot to freezing cold, and sometimes I can't even walk.
The group gets together twice a year.
Where's my girl?
And Turner has never missed a meeting.
Oh, love you.
I needed this so bad.
Now, if you want to minimize your chances of getting hit by lightning, go indoors or stay in your car.
When thunder roars, go indoors. There's a reason why we say that.
Still, the biggest threat isn't lightning hitting people. It's lightning starting fires.
Most forest fires are caused by humans, but most damage is done by lightning-caused wildfires. Usually because when lightning happens, it's not near a campground where you know it happened. It happens in some remote location that you may not know that the fire started right away.
Thunder and lightning were the weapons of Zeus, the most powerful god of all.
We may no longer believe that Zeus hurls lightning down from Mount Olympus when he's irritated, but there's still a lot we don't know.
Everybody thinks lightning, well, you must understand, it happens all the time. Like, and yet we don't.
I mean, I guess it's hard, right? Like, you can't really put a lightning bolt on your desk.
Right. The stuff that we see only lasts for, you know, maybe a millisecond.
Our best hope is to build instruments. In fact, Philip Bitzer himself helped develop a lightning camera that's on the space station at this moment.
And we're sitting above the Earth, looking down, just looking for these little blips of light sitting on top of clouds.
Is there any practical value toward mapping the lightning and how it happens, or is it just kind of neat?
We know that lightning will ramp up as a precursor to severe weather often, and so we can watch the lightning activity start to increase or start to jump. We've also been able to use it to help aviation. We can route planes around storms that are electrically active.
This is where I got a grasp on all the symptoms from the strike, so I'm holding on to the lightning bolt.
Back here on Earth, Shauna Turner is still fighting to recover from her lightning strike 8 years ago.
I mean, obviously the brain damage will never get any better, but I've learned how to do other things to assist with it. So I'm not going to let it stop me. If I let it stop me, it wins.
And in Arizona, 2 days after our visit, photographer Lori Bailey got some of that good luck she'd been chasing.
Oh, my goodness, giant bolts. Oh, baby, wow. Woo-hoo-hoo. Oh, my goodness. That was fantastic. This is where you feel alive and where you feel the energy of Mother Nature.